singers. I'm Justin Stoney, the founder of New York Vocal Coaching, welcoming you to episode 14 of Voice Lessons Online. This is the show where passionate voice teachers from all over the world help us learn from some of the greatest singers of all time. Today's singer, if you like rock, you love him. If you like theater, you love him. If you like pop, you love him. And if you like singing, well, love doesn't even begin to describe it. It's our friend, Adam Lambert. Just don't give up. I'm working it out. Please don't give in. I won't let you down. We are the champions, my friends. And we'll keep on fighting to the end.
I just wanna feel the
listen to that all day, but no time. Let's learn. First, Arbender Robinson. Tell us how Adam lives in different styles.
Hey there. So, question for you. If I asked you to tell me what style of music Adam Lambert sang, what would you say? I think a lot of people would say rock. But if I told you my first time ever hearing him sing, he was in the touring company of Wicked, the Broadway show. Or another time someone may have heard him sing, it would have been on Glee. Would that change the style of music that you think he sings? Well, what style of music do you think he's singing in this clip? Classical music. Listen to the way that someone that we think is a rock vocalist can change their vowels, can change the shape of their instrument, can change their breath support to really shift into a completely style, a different genre of music. That's amazing. And it's great when we see artists that can seamlessly and effortlessly do this. Check this one out. Check out this clip. Hearing an earlier form of rock music. I would call this boogie woogie or slightly rock and roll. Listen to the vowel sounds. Listen to the cutoffs. Listen to the way that we're either syncopating or not syncopating the rhythms or the breath support, how that completely changes the style of music. Now we're going to listen a little bit more. Listen to how the style or the genre of music shifts even as we are singing this same song. It slowly shifts through different genres until it gets all the way to rock that we're so used to hearing Adam do. Check this out. I gotta be good, relax, get hip, get on my tracks, take the best, and hitchhike, take a long ride on my motorbike until I'm ready. This crazy little thing called love. I can't handle this thing. If you get a chance, go back and listen again and see if you can notate all the different things that are shifting and changing as he is shifting from this classic rock, boogie-woogie rock and roll sound all the way through genres until we get to that rock sound that we know Adam to do so well. And in your own work, see if you can play with styles and genres of music in the same way to figure out what you need to do vocally to really live in these different styles of music. It is a sign of a truly, truly, truly great artist. Thanks.
Awesome, Arbender. Next, Kristy Bissell. What about Adam's tongue placement?
One of the things that I love about Adam Lambert is I never have to worry when I'm listening to him. There's some phenomenal singers out there that kind of put me on the edge of my seat. I'm like, are they going to do it? Are they going to do it? Oh, okay, they got it. Woo! All right. But my favorite kind of listening to singers is when I can sit back and be like, they got it. And I can focus on the story they're telling me, how I'm feeling, how I'm reacting to the music, versus, are they going to do it? Are they going to hit it? Adam Lambert never has a problem. I've not caught one. So one of the things that this guy is doing is he's sticking his tongue out on high notes. So before I can go further, you got to watch it. Okay. You see it? It's kind of getting flat too. Flatten out. Check out another one.
The only one that knows me, yeah, better than I know myself. Ooh, you keep my mind off the edge. If I wanted to leave, I would have left by now. But you're the only one that knows me, yeah, better than I know.
So what is this doing? Why is it working so well? So he's a pop singer. So larynx up is quite helpful for high notes and particularly freedom of sound. Just for a moment, put your fingers on your larynx. You feel it? And then, whoop, what's that? That's my tongue. And the tongue can either bulge from retraction, or you can stick it out. And when I stick it out, my larynx kind of goes up a little bit because they're both attached. They're not like separate entities. They're BFFs. They love doing things together. They don't have to. You can teach them to go separate ways, but they kind of like going together to places. So, you can play with this on one note. You can do, you can put your fingers here to feel it. But it's a wild experience, and I'm telling you, it really does help. The idea of low larynx on really high notes doesn't usually work, particularly for pop singers. So check it out, see if it helps you. Do the Adam Lambert tongue.
Thanks, Kristy. And Nicolás Hormazábal, what about Adam's use of distortion, twang, and compression?
Hi friends, I'm Nicolás Hormazábal from NYBC, and today we will analyze how Adam Lambert used vocal registers and twang in favor of rasp. Remembering, rasp is produced by the vibration of the vestibular folds, also called false calls. Basically, we can find two ways to bring vestibular folds close together, either from above or from below. We will start talking about how to bring vestibular folds close together from below. Compression is the secret. And Adam, especially at the beginning of the song, I want to break free, use more compression for a performance more aggressive and consequently falls into a heavy rasp. I want to break free. We can hear it here.
Break free. I want to.
Here,
God knows I want to break free.
And here,
I can't get over the way you love me like you do.
To approximate the vestibular folds from above, twang is the secret. If we don't take a lot of compression, this distortion sounds fancy.
God knows I want to break free.
Adam is quite smart to choose this rasp with less compression when he's setting riffs and runs because it's easier. We can hear this fancy distortion here.
Love for the first time, and this time I know.
Here.
I'ma live alone. Hey, God knows.
And here.
I walk out that door.
The way that Adam used vocal registers in twang to produce rasp is spectacular.
So good, sir. And Andy King, how does Adam maintain his uniqueness across many different genres?
Hi, everyone. Today, I want to chat about something that often comes up in the studio. I don't want to sound just like X artist, or how do I sound just like Y artist, or I don't want people to think I'm trying to mimic Z artist. Does this sound familiar? As a fellow singer, it has certainly come up for me in my singing. How do we balance honoring a certain artist and style while also remaining true to who we are? I think Adam Lambert is a fantastic example of this. Let's listen to a few clips of him covering other artists' songs.
Now I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body. I know not everybody.
Different songs originally performed by three very different artists covered by one Adam Lambert. He does an excellent job of honoring these three artists and genres while maintaining who he is as a singer. So I want to leave you with this. What do you as an artist and musician bring to the table? What can you as a creative share with the world? After all, there's only one you, and your voice is just as important as anyone else's.
Thanks, Andy, and thanks to all our experts. I'm going to share what I've learned from Adam in a moment, but first, here are some ways to rock your vocal journey.
To get to know the Voice Lessons Online team or schedule a lesson, visit voicelessonsonline.com. To get your copy of Justin Stoney's book, Sing Like Never Before, visit singlikeneverbefore.com. If you'd like a vocal course that you can do from home, check out the Voice Lessons to the World vocal course. Our 12-part program takes you on a journey from beginner to master-level vocal exercises. Find it at voicelessonstotheworld.com. If you're a voice teacher looking to master your craft, join our worldwide community at voiceteachertraining.com. Finally, if you'd like free vocal tips sent to you each day, sign up at dailyvocaltips.com.
Do you know what's the number one request in voice lessons? Vocal registration. Even when folks don't use this word, it's what they want. I mean, every singer wants to be able to sing low notes, middle notes, high notes, all with control and ease, right? The most important element in all of this is vocal registration. That means that the vocal folds figure out that they can actually be responsible for their own destiny. And nobody's vocal folds are more responsible than Adam's. Let me show you what I mean.
You keep pushing me aside and I can't break through. There's no talking to you.
Even though he's not singing high yet, you hear a multitude of register choices. Head dominant mix, 50-50 mix, chest dominant mix, falsetto, all in a matter of seconds. Anytime I hear a singer that has several register options in the low and middle range, I already know they're going to be able to rock up top. But let's listen to some more. Listen for the vocal fold control.
It's so sad that you're leaving. It takes time to believe it. after all that's said and done, you're gonna be the lonely one.
Do you hear it? Breathy, compressed, breathy, compressed, back and forth, back and forth, showing them chords what's what. So if he can do all of that in the middle voice, we expect he'll be able to do it up top. Why not? Same pair of vocal chords.
Do you believe in love after love? I can feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough now.
Yep, same skills, higher notes. Little more breathy, little more clean. Little more beef, little less beef. Or, of course, he could choose to add a lot more beef.
I don't need you anymore. I don't need you anymore. Do you believe in life after love? I can feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough.
Ooh, boy. And you guessed it. If he can do these things in the lows, the mids, and the highs, there should be absolutely no reason why he can't do it on the sky highs.
Do you believe in life after love? I can feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough.
I think we all have the same reaction as Cher. Wow. So thank you, Adam, for wowing us and inspiring us. I suppose if two little vocal folds no longer than the pinky nail can do all of that, then anything is possible. We'll see you next time for more voice lessons online.